Hello and welcome to the channel. It's puzzle time again with a new case with Sudoku Sleuth. Now, today's puzzle I've been framed by 99% sneaky was essentially impossible to pass up by this channel, given we are, of course, after all, sleuths that need to uncover these mysteries. So our mission today is absolutely to ensure that no innocent person goes down for a crime they have not committed. You may remember 99% sneaky, whom we featured on the channel before with a prison Sudoku puzzle. Now that puzzle was as beautiful as it looked. If you've not played that puzzle yet, I highly recommend that you do, and we'll leave a link to that video in the description down below as well. Now, on this channel, we are often solving Sudoku variants, meaning they're Sudoku puzzles with a twist that allows us to fill in a grid that's completely devoid of numbers. Now, 99% sneaky this time has generously given us 5 whole digits in the grid to solve today's mystery. So I imagine whoever is being framed for this crime is absolutely keen to prove that they are innocent today. Now, let's take a look at the rules for today's puzzle. Fairly simple, particularly compared to yesterday's puzzle where the rule sets were a whole paragraph on their own. So normal Sudoku rules apply, which means we need the digits 1 through to 9 in every row, column, and box in the grid. Digits in cages sum to the number in the top left corner of the cage. So all over the puzzle you can see these cages or dotted rectangles around. They are indeed all rectangles. And they will have a tiny number in the top that basically says these 2 digits or these 3 digits in this cage have to sum up to the number in there. And we've played with killer cages on the channel before. You may find a playlist for that also on this channel. So with that said, that's the rules for today's puzzle. We can probably take a look at getting started. Yes, if you want to play along, link in the description down below. And do let me know how you get on in the comments, because I really do immensely enjoy reading them. And if you've enjoyed today's solve, please give the video a like. With that said, let's get on with solving today's puzzle. Let me restart the clock and get going. Now, I'm immediately drawn to cages that essentially only have one way of filling it. So if you take a digit 3, for example, and if you want to use 2 digits to add up to a 3, and they have to be unique, then they have to be 1 and 2. No other 2 digits will give you 3. 4 over here will be 1 and 3. 7, there's only one way of doing that with 3 digits in the grid. Sorry, 3 digits in the cage. So that's 1, 2, and 4. And you can immediately see that this is helpful. So 1 and 2 means this is not a 1. 3, 1. Neither of these are 1. This is the 1. That's not a 2, so that's the 4, that's the 2. And we're off to an excellent start already. What else do we have that is relatively quick to play? So 5 over here, there's only 2 ways of doing 5 with 2 cells. So it's either 1-4, which would have to be this way around, or 2-3, which would have to be this way around. So despite having 2 possibilities, it's actually quite restricted already. In box number 4 here, so 7, you can do this in 1-6, gone, 2-5, gone. The only remaining option is 3-4. 8, you can do this in one of 2 ways with 3 digits. So you can do 1-2-5 or 1-3-4. In any scenario, you still need a 1. And this cell means it's no longer a 1. That's a 2, that's a 1. Obviously, the 2 removes one of the options out there. So it's no longer 1-2-5. This is a 1-3-4 cage. So I'm not going to do this, but you can see over here the 7 cage and these 8 cage. They have very similar digits. So if this was a 1, for example, and I'm fairly sure it isn't, how would you be able to solve this puzzle to a unique solution? But rather than assume it is a unique puzzle, we're going to prove that indeed it is. So this is just looking for any other cages that are just obvious to place, but nothing necessarily is standing out to me at this point. Yeah. Okay, let's look elsewhere now. So we've got these sevens, and in particular in box three, if we start with that. So this seven could be a 1-7, can't be a 2-5 or a 3-4. So these are from 1, 3, 4, and 6. Now, if we take a look at this seven, so this is seeing these three digits. Both are seeing these three digits. So this can only be a 2-5. If it was a 3-4, for example, we've eliminated too many options and we end up with a triplet of 1-6 that we're going to have to place, which is, again, not possible today. So 2-2, we know we need a 2 in here. We need a 1 up there because of this one. Therefore, this is not a 6. Let's take a look at the 9 in here. So we have 1 and 2 and are gone. So we've got 3-6. And indeed, that's the only option because 4-5 is not available with a 5 gone in here. 3-6. Right, so it's a little bit more complicated here. So if this was a 3-4, no, that's fine. Pardon me, I thought if this is a 3-4, this would require a 6 in here, but clearly that's not a problem. And a 3 in here, we know the 1 is here, the 6 is in here, so all of that does indeed work. 1, 3, 4, though, in the column tells us that this is the 6, so that's 6, that's 1, that's 3, that's 6. And this is now a 3-4 cage. We've got the order of that as well, 4 and 3. To complete the box, we need 5, 7, and 9. I'm just going to fill them in, even though there isn't anything that would help us progress the puzzle just yet. So 8 has to be down here. 7 has to be up here. To complete row 1, we need a 7 and an 8. And then we're left with 2, 5, 6. We know the 6 is in here. And these are 2 and 5. That's not 5. To complete this row now, we need 7, 9, or 4. And the 4 has to be in here. But let's put all of these options in for a second. That's not 7. And 4 has to be here. We need 5. No, we don't need that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We need 7, 8, and 9 again. And that's not 7. Nothing's looking at that one here tells us. Did I do this the correct way around then? So that's not 1, that's 4, that's 1, that's 4, that's correct. Nothing really tells us though what's in there. Let's take a look elsewhere. So this could be a 1-7-2-6, but not 3-5. Still feels like too many options. If we look at the 7, so that's not 1, 2, 3, or 4. This could be, we'll call it 5, 6, 7. Not sure all these options are available. 5 would go with a 2. 1, it's not 7. Sort of wondering if, I imagine whoever is watching this video is probably screaming at something that is so obvious, but somehow I'm still missing. Let's start asking other questions. Where does 9 go in the column? It can only go in one of two places. And over here, one of three places. The fact that they're all not 9 just makes me very suspicious around. Is this another way of making progress in the puzzle? Let's take a look at column 7 regardless, we have a lot of the cells already known. So 1, 2, 3, 4 are gone. We do need an 8. The 8 is not in here. The 8 is in here. So we're left with 5, 7, and 9 to place. 9 cannot go in here. 7 cannot go in here because of this one, which required a 7, 1 in that order. So this is the 5. This is 7 and 9. And this is 3. That's not 3. So 8 must be very restricted now. We need a 1, 7 pair. Or still 2, 6. So that's not changed, unfortunately. I'm just going to pencil these in and take a look at the column. So 1, 7 possible, 2, 6. 2, 6 is not possible. And explain why when you look at this cage here. So this is either a 1, 6 cage, which excludes 2, 6, or a 2, 5 cage, which also excludes 2, 6. So if we end up with a 2, 6 in here, it breaks this 7 killer cage. So that's 2, 5 now. We're left with a 9 in here. And we need to place a 6 in the column. This 1, 7 pair tells us that this is a 4, a 9, 7 is up here, 5. And we're left with a 1, 3 pair in this cage. Now, to complete this box, we need 4, 7, and 9. That's not 7. We need 2 and 6. Still feels like a solve is quite far away. Whoever framed this individual has done it extremely well. So, this is either 1, 6, 2, 5 is not possible, 3, 4 is not possible. So, that is 1, 6. One is somewhere in here with these. 1, 6 tells us that this is a 3, 2, 5, 2, 5 has to be in here. This cell is quite restricted. So you can see we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6 and 8. So we're left with 7 and 9 only in this cell. Now to complete the column, you can see we still need a 1. Which this isn't. So that's the 1. That can only be a 7 or a 9. Because we've got the 8 looking at it from here. So that is the 8. That's the 7. And then we have a 7-9 pair in this column to complete it. And let's keep going. We need a 5 in here. This 2 has already been looking at this for a while. That's a 6, that's a 2, that's a 7, that's a 1. So to complete this row, we need 5, 8, and 9. That's an 8. Two can only go in this box in here because of this 2 in box 9. And to complete the box, we need 4, 7, and 8, joined with a 3, 6 pair. And we do know the order. That's a 6, that's a 3. And to complete the box now, we need 4, 7, and 9. So that's 4, that's 7, that's 9. Column, we need an 8 and a 4, 9. We don't know. 4 cannot be in here, so the 4 has to be down there, allowing us to complete box 7. And over here, we still need an 8, 9. Therefore, that's the 7. That's a 5, 6 pair. We know the order. That's a 5. Fives have to be in here now, and we still don't know the order of that, surprisingly. That's not a 7. That's a 4-9 pair. That is the 7. Don't know a lot about box 5 still, surprisingly. So let's take a look at the most complete row. This is from, well, 3 can actually be placed. Then we also need a 6, which can also be placed, and that's a 4-9, and we don't know the order of that just yet. This 6 helps. It's 1-6. 1s are restricted now, so that's 1-3-1. 4-3. Still need a 2. That's the 2. That's 5. That's 2. 5 will probably tell us that the 5 must go in here. This is 1 of 4, 8, and 9, all of which is possible for the moment. That's not 4. We need 7 and 8 in here. That's 8. That's 9. That's 8. That's 7. Neither of these are 7. This has to be 9. Probably haven't been staying on top of my pencil marking, since it still requires a little bit of thought to spot what's left in here. Yeah, that 9 here means that's the 8. That's the 4. That's the 9. That's the 7. Or, if I've not made any mistakes, that's the 8. And that's the solution for today's puzzle. So, I hope you have enjoyed this, and we finally freed whoever's been framed accidentally, or perhaps intentionally even. And please do let me know how you got on, and see you all back tomorrow.